So welcome back. We are continuing with our design of footer bridge, right? So in the previous session, if you remember, we have calculated the forces in the inclined member, right? We have calculated the forces in the inclined members, forces in the vertical members, sorry, not inclined members, forces in the vertical members. So here we are going to find out forces in the inclined, or you can say diagonal members. So if you can see your truss, there is a diagonal member like this, right? So we know the vertical height V, right? Let us denote this at V, then this angle will be a theta angle, and this will be my diagonal, right? So if I want to find out sine theta is equal to V divided by D. Sine theta will be equal to V divided by D. So therefore my D will become V divided by sine theta, or I can write this as V times cosec theta. V times cosec theta, right? So D becomes V times cosec theta. Right. Now force in diagonal members is equal to force in vertical member multiplied by cosec theta with negative sign. So force in diagonal member will be equal to negative sign force in vertical member multiplied by cosec theta, right? Force in vertical member multiplied by cosec theta. So this is the formula that we are using. So here we have a theta is equal to 45 degree. Right, so we have a theta 45 degree because height is 3 meter and length is also 3 meter. So if we calculate theta, theta will be 45 degree. So therefore cosec theta, therefore will be 1 upon sine theta. So if I put theta is equal to 45 degree, so 1 upon sine 45, I'll get the value as 1.414. So cosec 45, I'm getting the value as 1.414. So now let us calculate the forces. So I need to prepare a table for that. Okay, so let's prepare a table. So first column will be for name of vertical member. Then next column will be force in member, maximum and minimum. In kilonewton units, one is maximum, one is minimum. Then third I have diagonal member. And in the last column, I have force in diagonal member that is equal to negative sign force in vertical member multiplied by 1.414. So this is a typical table that you are supposed to prepare. Alright, so first you need to refer your figure that we have drawn in the previous lectures. So what are the vertical member? First one is U0 L0, then U1 L1, then U2 L2, U3 L3. Right, up to U3 L3, then other is a symmetric. Then if you remember, if you see the calculations of the previous lectures, we have force in the member U1 L1 as 279.3 maximum. Then U1 L1 we have two forces, 202.65, and one is next one is 83.85. So 202.65, and second force is, I think it is 83.85. Then in U2L2, 132.6 and 39.3. 132.6 and 39.3. And last, U3L3, I have 68.85 and minus 11.55. 68.85 and minus 11.55 kilonewton. Then diagonal members. So again, refer the figure. So first diagonal member is U0L1, then U1L2, U2L3, and the last one is U3L4. And last, force in diagonal members is equal to negative sign force in vertical member multiplied by 1.414. So I'll get first value as minus 395. Here also there is minimum and maximum, so minus 395, then minus 286.5, minus 286.5. You are getting this 286.5 by multiplying this value 202.65 by 1.414. So again, 83.85 multiplied by minus 1.414. So I'll get my answer is minus 118.56. Minus 118.56. Then third, I'm getting minus 187.5. Minus 187.5. And other value, minimum value is minus 55.6. This is maximum and this is minimum. And last member, minus 97.07, minus 97.07, and plus 16.33. Here I am having plus because it is multiplied with minus. So minus 11.55 multiplied by minus 1.414. So I get this value, right? So this is how you can calculate the forces in the diagonal members. Alright. So the shape of influence line diagram for diagonal members will be same as that of vertical members, but it will be opposite in nature. I am talking about shape here, right? So shape of influence line diagram for this diagonal member is same as for the vertical members, but it will be opposite in nature. Right? So this is one of the important thing to be remembered, right? So with this, we have completed our force calculations, right? So in the next session, we'll start with our designs, right? So we're going to design top chord member, bottom chord member, vertical member, inclined members using IS 800-2007, right? So thank you so much for watching. Keep learning, keep practicing.